Josh Raven here with the Daily Dot at IEM Katowice, joined by Anders, one of the casters here at the tournament, of course. And I just want to jump straight into things, looking at the tournament as a whole. It's just started, early days, obviously, of course. But as you come in, you're looking at your Fnatic, Envious, kind of your favourites. However, there's been a bit few underdog stories coming in, Luminosity, Na'Vi, Astralis, and Verse Pro, teams like that. Do you think there's any chance of these teams causing some sort of an upset or getting further in the bracket stage than you'd expect them to? Or do you think it's pretty much a lock-on for these top teams?
No, I don't think it is. I mean, I think Envy have shown a lot of signs of not weakness, but just instability in general. Probably some internal stuff, I imagine. They've been playing together for a while. It seems to always happen in the French scene anyway. Fnatic have been struggling a bit. They obviously lost to Luminosity, which is amazing, on Inferno, but now they're playing NiP right now, actually, and they're struggling a little bit there. So, I'd say even Fnatic showing some sign of trouble, but they always play better at the playoffs anyway, so who knows. Astralis, I've heard rumors from other teams and themselves, obviously, that they've been playing well. I don't know if I should believe that whenever a team tells me that they're playing well, but you know. No, I'd say this is a pretty open tournament, actually. Definitely.
One of the teams coming into the tournament that people are kind of focusing on, well, there are two teams, actually. We'll start with NIP. They've just made their roster change, obviously bringing in Pyth or Pith, whatever you say.
I think it's Pith.
Pith?
Pith, yeah.
Okay, they're bringing in Pith. And, you know, a lot of Pith fans, they're not sure if that's really the change that they need, and a lot of teams saying that maybe the core of the team needs to be split up eventually, finally, after all these years. What do you think about that? Do you think that they can get to the great days again, or do you think it's time to cut it loose?
And I think the problem is the great days for NiP were days when there was only one other team that even knew how to play the game. So it's not to try and take a thing away from what NiP did back then, but it's just to say that no other team, I think, will almost be able to do that. And it is sort of nuts that Fnatic have been able to do what they've been doing already. But no one should be able to get back to that level where they can just roll over. And you see even now Fnatic are beginning to reach a point where it's even against teams like Luminosity, and so it's becoming really hard. Splitting up the core group, I don't know, that's a very tough, it's a tough question to answer. I don't think Pith is a bad pickup at all, because I think people mistakenly think that they have to pick up someone who is going to like carry the team, and I think they already have those players. I still think Get Right and Forest are some of the best players in the world, so I think it's a little bit ridiculous to suggest that they would have to pick up, you know, steal all of Meister from Fnatic or something like that. I don't think that's necessary, but I mean, my worry for this tournament is that they haven't had enough time to use Threat in the team as their coach, and that he hasn't had enough time to have an effect on the team. So, otherwise, I think it's a good team. And I think that was NiP.
Yeah. Good for them. I hear they're probably winning. The other team quickly I wanted to touch on as well was Virtus Pro. They've had a pretty rough start to the year, but you know, it's Virtus Plow or Virtus Throw, whatever you want to call it. They are at home in front of their home crowd, but they have had a really shocky start to the year. Do you think that playing in front of their home crowd will get them riled up enough? Do you think they can kind of bring it back to fix their bad start?
Yeah, but they got to get to the home crowd first of all, right? They got to make it out of that group, and it's not necessarily an easy group. I don't know. Honestly, I was disappointed when they took a break from right after DreamHack Winter all the way till DreamHack Leipzig. So that's a month and a half nearly that they weren't playing anything. And then they showed up, and it turns out they hadn't really been doing anything. And I think that's a mistake. I think they should have spent not all of that time, but maybe the last 2 weeks or something, setting a game plan and sort of say, all right, it's a new year, let's get into it, let's show that we could do something here. When they came in, the Katowice major that they won in 2014, when they came into that, there were all these rumors. Every team was saying, we don't know how to beat Virtus Pro, they're so good. I mean, they're defeating us all over the place. I haven't heard anything like that. I'm actually a bit worried for VP, I definitely am. I don't think teams ever like lose the ability to play the game. It's like you're suddenly like, you know, 6 months later, like, I've lost it, I can't play anymore. But you could surely lose focus, and you could not practice, and then things go really bad. So I hope that's not what's happening, but I'm definitely worried.
Okay. Well, moving away from Katowice as a tournament, we're moving into more of the grand landscape of Counter-Strike. Obviously, recently, the major prize pools got released. They're going up to $1 million. E-League is coming in with a big prize pool as well. And I wanted to ask if you think that these increasing prize pools from these tournaments should kind of set the standard for what these tournaments should be offering, or if you think it would be better if they, like the majors, were left as their own premier-level tournament worth more than the other tournaments, perhaps?
So, I mean, there was a lot of feedback on Reddit when that got announced, people saying, well, you know, Dota has 3 million, why Counter-Strike only 1 million? You know, we should obviously be at least at 3 million, and, you know, it seems unfair and all this. I think people maybe don't understand like what the ecosystem of Counter-Strike is. If, I mean, already the increase to $1 million has made life very tough for a bunch of leagues that maybe were thinking about announcing or maybe were going to do something. I don't think Valve made a mistake in doing that. I think they should increase it. But if they increase it to $3 million, then that actually kills a bunch of leagues. Winning a bit more.
I assume we'll edit that a little bit.
I can sort of watch it out of the corner of my eye. I'm like, damn. All right, so people who make investments into esports, they make it at the beginning of the year. So if you invest into a league and that league is, you know, you say, well, that league is already $1 million combined, and then Valve show up and drop in $3 million at the major, then you're going to feel like you didn't get your money's worth, and it'll be worse for sponsors, worse for the people who invest into the game. So I think I definitely want to see the A majors end up at $3 million, but it has to be like an incremental thing. They can't just like drop $3 million all of a sudden. In my opinion, that would be sort of shooting their own product in the foot essentially. So I think they made the right choice definitely. But there also has to be like a correlation between sort of prize pool and production value and general tournament sort of value. It is a bit meaningless to have, you know, $5 million. Well, I hate throwing shots at Dota, but it's a bit meaningless to have a $3 million Dota tournament in Shanghai that then, you know, isn't following up on it. You know, I don't think Dota are looking at Counter-Strike now and saying, say Dota as a whole, but I think a lot of Dota people are thinking, well, if we could have had $1 million but then had a much better show, it would have been better anyway. So, yeah, I think there has to be some sort of correlation there.